Hello friends, welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial we are going to look about how to establish many to many mapping in Hibernate. In previous video tutorial we have learned how to perform or how to implement one to many mapping in Hibernate, and I have created another project with many to many mapping, and all codes I have copied from my previous this example to in this project. So in this project basically earlier we had implemented a one to many mapping between employee and address, and that's what we have a one to many mapping over here. In this video tutorial let's see how, suppose let's take a scenario, suppose one user can have a multiple addresses, right? And one addresses can be associated with the multiple employees. So that's the example of many to many association. So here from employee side, and one thing you will have to always keep in mind, when you have a one to many mapping, then this relationship can be defined within the two table itself, right? So rather than creating the join table, you can maintain this relationship in the two table itself. In many side association you can create a foreign key of the single side reference, right? And that's what we have learned in the previous video tutorial. But if you have a many to many association, then always will have a join table. These things you will have to keep in mind. Now here instead of specify one to many, what I'm going to do, I'm going to specify many to many, right? And let's make an import from the javax.persistence itself. Now one thing you will have to specify over here, as of now mapped by, I'm going to remove over here. Now now another side, so from employee to address you have a many to many relationship. From address side also you can define a many to many relationship. So in earlier video tutorial we have defined many to one, so that I'm going to remove. Let's remove, or what we can do, let's remove the setters and getters. And from here also what we can do, we can to take a collection of list, or list of what I can take here, you can take a collection or list or set, whatever you want. So here I'm gonna take a collection, right? So basically list extends collection, and like array list implements a list interface, right? So of course you can take in left side, you can take a collection. Now what I'll do, emp list something, sorry. So here you can specify this variable name as emp list. Now what I'm going to select the one of the list implementer, it's called list array list. So any implementation you can take list implementation. So most frequently used one is array list, so that I have taken only. Let's make an import from java.util.collection, right? And here also you can specify many to many, right? Okay, let's make an import. Now after specifying this, and let's go to the client program. You might get some error in the client program. So if I go to fetching data from the database, I'm going to delete this file as of now. So we'll talk it fetching or reading data from the database, that is very easier. So here you have a one employee, right? And one employee can have a many addresses. So here what I'm going to do, I'm going to create one more employee object. So let's create let's say this is employee one, and let's create employee two as well. So this is our employee two. Okay, so Barry Bingle, here you can say Sean Bingle, and you can say Sean, let's say salary is 70,000, something like this, right? You have an address object, there are two addresses object, right? There are two address objects. So let's create one more copy of address. So here let's say this is address 3. These things I'm going to delete, so we'll associate these things from scratch so that we will have better understanding. Now address 3, sorry, here was supposed to be Pune. Now here I would say Delhi. Now zip code, just specify some fake zip code, and you can say DH or DL, you can say, and PQR street, right? So we have a 3 references of address. Now in employee you have a, if you look into the employee, then what you can say, employee dot get address list dot add, we can assign address 1 to employee 1. So what I can do, we can assign 3 addresses to employee 1, address 1, 2, and 3. Similarly you have a bi-directional relationship, so again what we have to do here in address side, what you will have to dictate setter and getter for this guy. So what you can do, you can have a set emp list, and you can have a get emp list, right? Now go to the client program again. Here what you can do, you can have address side, you can make call to address dot get emp list, and you can have add from address 1 you can associate employee 1, right? And similarly you have address 2 yes, so here basically address 1, address 2 is associated with the address 1, 2, 3 is associated with employee 1. So address 1 you can save the reference of employee 1. Similarly we'll have to save 3 times over here. So similarly address 2 associated with employee 1, address 3 is also associated with employee 1, right? So similarly you can have something, suppose here you can see employee 2, maintaining address 2 and address 3, so employee 2 is having 2 addresses. Similarly you can associate these things. So this is bi-directional relationship, that's why I'm saving the both references. So suppose address 1, 2 and 3 is associated with the employee 2 itself, right? So that's all, it's pretty straightforward, right? Now once you done with this, then in this case Hibernate is going to create a join table as well, right? So there is 2 tables, let's drop it out from this schema and let's run this program. Now again Hibernate is going to generate a join table, and table name would be the default one, right? So as we have seen in the many to one association, so there is a problem. Let's see what happens now. I think there is some problem. What we have done, we are trying to save employee 2. We are also trying to save, we need to save these 2 employees, right? Employee 1 and employee 2. And let's see, we have given cascade type or not over here. So cascade type all. So let's save, let's try it out again. At this time everything ran successfully, but what I'll do, I'll clean the database and let's try to run it again. So I'm going to drop all those tables, and just I have made our schema clean slate, and let's try to run it again. Now you can see on the Eclipse console, Hibernate has created a table is called address. Then Hibernate is trying to create the join table, and that is basically derived from the concatenation of these 2 tables, and address ID as well as employee ID as declared as the foreign key over here, and name is also derived one, and employee table is getting created, and join table again, there are 2 join tables is created basically, and in this join table, employee ID as well as address ID is declared as a foreign key. And here in these two, basically they have defined that a foreign key over here, right? Basically, first that added the constraint and that is defined as a foreign key over here. Now here, if you come down, then after triggering all the DDL query, basically, so why you are looking here so much queries, because there are two join tables has been created, that's the reason. And finally, you can see one insertion in the table, employee table, and now three addresses belongs to the employee one, so that's why three insertion. Now employee two, second insertion on the employee two for that employee two, and there are, you can see in join table also there are various entries, right? So if you go here and you can clarify from here, so here you can see in employee table there would be two entries. Now if you go to the address table, there would be, you will get the 1, 2, 3 entries, and but which address belongs to whose employee, that you can get from this. So here Hibernate has created two join table, right? And both will contain the almost same data. So if you look into the employee table, address table, then you can see employee address 1, 2, 3 belongs to the employee 1 itself, and address 2 and 3 belongs to the employee 2 itself. Why Hibernate is creating two tables? Because here, when you look into the Hibernate in this table, and that makes the association between employee and address, and that's the reason that creates one table. And name, you can look at this table name, employee table underscore address table. Again, employee looks on the other side, and Hibernate says the Hibernate looks, there is also collection, and that creates one more join table. And table name, you can see address table underscore employee table, but both table contains the same data. So you can tell the Hibernate to not to create these two table but one table. How you can do that? So what you will have to do, in any side you can go and you can tell mapped by, and here you can specify the mapped by this variable name. So what you are telling, so this relationship creation table is all taken care by the another side, so you don't care about this. So when Hibernate looks into this entity class, that creates the join table, but when Hibernate look into this side, then clearly you are saying this is already being mapped by another side, so you don't create the extra table, extra joining table. Let's drop these tables and let's try to run and see how many tables are getting created now. Now this issue should have resolved. And one more thing, joining table name gets derived, right, by default, and that joining table name also we can specify, right? We don't want the joining default joining table, and that we had almost done in our previous videos, so that I wanted to copy, but that's not a problem. Here I'm running out of time, that's the reason I wanted to copy, but let's run this program and how we had defined the join table in the one to many, similar concept you can apply to create the join table. And if I go and refresh, then you can see at this time address table is created, three addresses, two employees, right? And you can look under the table name, so that gets created by concatenating these two tables. And here these things also, you can now only one table is created for the mapping, right? But this table name as well as this column name, foreign key column name, you can of course customize by using add join table, right? So that's all I wanted to show in this video tutorial. So I hope I'm running out of time, that's the reason I'm not going to define joining table. So where you have to define the join table, that you will have to understand, because here you are specifying mapped by address list, right? So you are telling Hibernate this is already being mapped by this guy, so you don't care about this. So that's the reason you will have to specify the join table here itself, right? So you will have to write join table name equal to whatever name you want. You can have a join column and inverse join column, and that will create the that will modify the table name as well as column name, foreign key column. So thanks for watching this video, and see you next video tutorial.